You okay there, pal?
Yeah. But you better run, because I'm poisoned, and I might contaminate your life.
Haven't you heard? I live dangerously. Anything I can do?
Can you turn back the clock?
To before the baby, you mean?
That'd be good. That'd be my first choice. I'd actually settle for a couple hours ago. Any time before Sonny realized that I was the person that he hates. You know, when I was carrying Sonny's child, I felt so special, you know, for the first time in my life. He didn't just take care of me. He cared for me, you know. I mean, at first, he was just putting up with me, but then it changed, you know, it really did change, and he was happy that I was there, and he was happy to be with me. Even after I lost the baby, things were still really good between us. So, it's painful, you know. But we were together. And then, it's just like somebody flipped a switch and it's gone. I don't know who I'm kidding. It was me. People like to say that I'm my own worst enemy, you know, people who know me well. And it really makes me furious because deep down inside I know that it's true. I have this chronic disease and I just gotta get rid of it.
Does it have a name?
Destroy everything that makes you happy disease.
Well, the cure for that is to go to Sonny and explain yourself. Say you're sorry.
He doesn't want to hear it.
Well, he probably does want to hear it. And even if he doesn't, what's the worst that can happen? I mean, could you feel any more unhappy than you feel right now, sitting here alone in the dark?
I'm not alone. Got you. I'm kind of in the middle of a conversation right now.
Something that can't wait. I gotta get to the club, actually.
I'm sure Sonny doesn't mean to run you off, Roy.
It's not a problem. Hey, man.
Hey, Roy.
Okay, well, thanks for being so nice. It's a rarity in men these days,
yeah,
it seems.
Yeah, don't mention it.
So what's up? You have an overwhelming desire to yell at me, tell me what a disgusting tramp I am again?
Nothing like that. Just came to apologize. I'm gonna try to get this out. Can you just sit there for a minute and not interrupt?
Sure.
Is that even a remote possibility?
Of course it is.
This is not meant to excuse how you treated Elizabeth. First in my home, then out in public, twice so far this week. Unacceptable. Absolutely.
Sonny, wait a minute. If this is going to be another lecture about how I should respect the sanctity of Elizabeth Weber, then I'll take a big fat pass.
Is this how you keep quiet? I'm trying to apologize, and then, you know what? Forget it.
No, Sonny, wait. Don't go. You know what? I'm sorry. I'm going to sit down, and I want to hear what you have to say, and I'm just going to be really quiet. I'm not going to say anything. I really want to hear.
You swear to God.
I want to hear what you have to say. Please.
All right. Like I said, your behavior with Elizabeth is inexcusable, but mine wasn't any better. You make me crazy. You bulldoze yourself into a situation you know nothing about. You start yapping. and it makes things worse.
Okay,
well, all I'm saying.
I know
I'm
supposed to be silent here, but if this is your idea of an apology, you got to take it back to the drawing board.
Well, you need to stop and think before you open your mouth and go off on people. That's all I'm saying. There's always a reason things go down. If you would just wait to hear it, you wouldn't get so mad and turn around and get me mad.
Okay, but I just hope that someday I can aspire to, you know, set off the same kind of defense reflexes in you that Elizabeth sets up without even having it try.
You see, that's what I'm talking about. What I'm trying to make you understand is a separate issue from
Elizabeth
entirely.
Wait a minute, what? We have issues now?
Okay. When we start to fight, one of the first things you do is put yourself down, then you try to make it like it's the way I feel. You start saying, you know, you're trash, you're a slut. Those are your words, Carly, not mine. But then you push my buttons, and I let you think that I agree. But the bottom line is, you lost your temper, I lost mine, and I should have come down on you so hard, and I'm sorry about that.
Finally. You're not very good at this whole apology thing.
Well, you're such an expert.
I'm better than you.
Well, that's because you got more practice.
Well, I'm not going to deny that, but I'm better than you. Would you like me to demonstrate?
Knock yourself out.
Well, you just got to come right out and say it. I'm sorry, too, son, because you're right. I know that I'm like that. Jason used to tell me that all the time. You know, he used to say that I need to stop and think about what I'm doing before I make assumptions.
Wrong assumptions.
Okay. I don't want to, and I don't mean to. It's like the programmed response or something.
Wipe the floor with someone and ask questions later.
I can't promise you I'll never do it again either, but I can say that I will definitely try my best not to, if that counts for anything.
Counts.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Because I don't want to fight with you. Mm-hmm.
Feeling's mutual. Now, you want me to drive you to the brownstone so you can fight with Bobby instead?
That'd be nice. The company, I mean.
Are you saying that you kind of miss me a little bit?
Don't get ahead of yourself, okay?
Let's go.